Hey, what's up, guys? I'm gonna do a little vlogging today, mixed with some Fear of God unboxing. It's my cousin's birthday. I feel cousin is like not a good description. He's literally like my brother. We shared a room together. We lived in the same house for years. He works with me. I mean, he's more than my brother. Like, I love him to death. He turns 33 tomorrow, but we're celebrating his birthday today. We're going to be eating at a Korean restaurant, one of our favorite places to eat, Sundubul, aka Tofu Soup, Korean restaurant. I got him some dope-ass Fear of God, actually. I told myself I'm not going to buy anything from the Fear of God sale, but I bought something from the first sale. Now there's another sale. It was like 50% off. How could I say no? I also got myself a jacket, too. So I'll show you. I'm actually going to wear that today for my birthday. I'm going to... And in the comments, someone told me, hey, I should put an outfit together. So I figured, you know what? I'll do like a unboxing, put a fit together, and vlog for today's video. So I hope you guys enjoy spending the day with me. I don't usually drink, but I started getting into wine. Shout out to my boy, Roger Orlando. He's an attorney here in Atlanta, too. And he's been collecting wine. He's got like a, I don't know, $2 million wine collection. I'm not trying to collect like that. I'm not even trying to collect, I'm just drinking. But I got into wine. So let me show you what I got here. I'm about to start my day with a small glass. I don't really like to drink. I used to like to get trashed when I was younger. And then I turned into a dad and then stop getting trashed. And then if you're not gonna get trashed, like, what is the point of drinking, is how I always thought of it. But now that I've gotten into wine, I don't like getting trashed. I like that nice, just kind of very chill, even buzz that wine gives you. I'm Korean, so when I drink alcohol, my face turns red. Not every Korean is like that, but a lot of Koreans are. But when I drink French wine in particular, I don't get red when I drink, which is really bizarre to me. This is my favorite wine. This is called Lynch Baj, aka also called Lunch Bags. It's expensive. It's about $100, $150 for a bottle on average. These are 2021s. These are special to me. This is 2006, which is my graduation year from college at Emory, where I met my wife. These are 2016s, which is the birth year of my first daughter, who I love dearly. These are 2019. These are 100-pointer Lynch Bajos. And then these are bangers right here. Rothschild, Latour. These are two of the best wines. What all these wines have in common, though, the Lynch Baj, the Rothschild, the Latour, they are all Pauillac region wines. These are bangers here, too. Decam. These are also... Pauillac region wines, but most of these are relatively affordable. But these right here, this is like, I think $800, saving these for a special occasion. It smells good to you, it tastes good to you, then you're Gucci. Doesn't need to be expensive. And I would also say, like, it doesn't have to be expensive wine to be a good wine. There's plenty of good wines for, you can find in like the $30 range. But I'm going to put on my monocle, be super hoity-toity, and tell you that my favorite is Lynch Baj. And if you're paying $100 a bottle, $150 a bottle for wine, I would say that's on the very expensive side. All right, my day's ready to go. This is my favorite zip-up hoodie. I'm not a zip-up hoodie guy. I like the pullover hoodies much better. But when I saw this on 8th Collection, my wife is actually the one who got the black one. She likes to wear her super oversized, so she bought a large. I tried it on. It feels so good. So I bought myself one in brown or mocha, whatever color they call it. And I had been debating about getting this one, this colorway, the cream, for a long time. And I didn't. And now that it's Tim's birthday, I was like, you know what? Let me pick this up for Tim. This hoodie, it feels so good. You know, I use the same descriptions all the time when buying Fear of God. And I'm going to be honest with you guys. I'm not that hyped about the 8th collection, and now there's going to be this like symposium collection or whatever it's called. But the one thing that Fear of God always does and always does right, their hoodie jogger set. I wear a large. I like mine oversized. Tim is a little bit shorter than I am, and he likes a more crop look. I think the way like Jerry intended it to be worn. This color is fucking beautiful. Not yellow, not quite cream, almost like a eggshell color. I think originally priced like $800, which is way too much. But at 50% off, I think totally worth it. Whoops, sorry for the crotch in your face, you guys. And you know what? Medium looks great. Maybe I should have bought medium. I'm like 6'1", 6'2" on a good day. I don't really like it too cropped.
I like the way the large fits me. I've never tried a medium, actually. This is the first time I'm trying a medium. And I'll say the medium actually fits me pretty damn good. This hoodie right here like encapsulates what I love about Fear of God. It's simple, it's clean, it's modern. It goes with everything, it's timeless. Everything I like about clothing, this hoodie fits into that. It's every day, but it can also be dressed up. I think it makes it makes a great gift for anyone. So if you're looking for a birthday gift, go to Mr. Porter, go to Fear of God. They're doing a lot of sales for 8th Collection stuff right now. Now I'm going to unbox what I got from the Fear of God sale. This is not from Mr. Porter. This is from the actual Fear of God website. I like the moleskin jacket. I liked it also in brown, although the concrete was kind of sexy. I like this mocha color. Been really into military vibes, kind of gives military vibes. I've also really been into tailoring, so it's a nice little combination of both. And also ties in my love of Fear of God also. Lined very nicely. Feels very silky and smooth. I don't know what moleskin is. Like, is it really moleskin? Like the animal that's a mole, the skin? Let's see, there are no buttons. Or it appears as if there's no, yeah, there are no buttons. Are there no buttons? Oh, that is a lie. There is a button. So this is the cuff, and there is a button. Is it and it's a functional button, so that's nice, but it's just one button. I'm guessing maybe so you can like roll it up, roll the sleeves up or whatever. Very casual. Feels good. My wife was like, you should return it. It's not that cool. I've been wearing a lot of Celine tailoring. She's like, you should just get another Celine jacket. But it's a different thing. It's not like a suit jacket. It's got blazer vibes, but it's definitely much more edgier, less like conservative. I think it's fun. And I like dressing up these days, like dressing up, like tailoring dressing up, not just like t-shirts or like a button down and jeans. But I'm definitely dressing this down today. I like it. Feels good. I know there's people that like, they swear that they dress from the sneakers up, like they decide what sneaker they're gonna go with and go up. I kind of pick like one central piece that I wanna wear, and then everything kind of revolves around that central piece that I intend to wear. This jacket is my central piece, and from here, I'm gonna decide what else to do. And I wanna go casual, so probably like a t-shirt, maybe a button down over it. I wanna layer this up. I'm definitely doing jeans. Yeah, I'm just gonna go plain Jane Levi's right here. This Oasis t-shirt, my favorite band. Go with this vintage band tee. Well, it's not really vintage, but go with that. All right, so as you can see, like just with the tee and the jacket, it's fine. I kind of like how the green and the brown kind of ties all the colors in together, but slightly boring, right? We're going to a birthday party, so I want it to be a little bit more fun than that. So I'm gonna layer it up, throw another button down. We're gonna go Fear of God. Haven't worn this in a while, just got it dry cleaned. Denim button down. I think this might be 8th Collection. It might be Eternal, I can't remember. Okay, I was gonna do jeans, but I think it's just too much denim. Like the denim shirt with the denim jeans. It's not a bad look, but I think we need to kind of vary up the color palette here. I wasn't trying to do sweats, especially because we're about to go eat tofu soup and I don't want to splatter any of it on there, but I'm gonna have to make the sacrifice for style here and just eat very, very carefully and make sure none of my kids touch me with their greasy little fingers. Okay, so my wife completely switched up my look. She says I need to go French girl summer because I look too hot, which I kind of agreed. It was a little maybe too autumn-y. We're at the end of July here. So she picked out a different jean for me. She said go Fear of God jeans, which really can't go wrong. And then a classic throwback Fear of God. I think this is like from 4th or 5th collection.
My wife usually never dresses me. I never really go for what she tells me to do, but I think this works out. So I've got the main pieces now, and I just got to accessorize. I always pick my sneakers last based on what I'm wearing, but I'm pretty sure I'm going to go with like the Fear of God 7th collection sneakers, like leather sneakers, very chill, casual. I need to pick my scent, and I need to pick my eyewear and my watch, and I'm good to go. My brain is dead from all the alcohol. Fill it with lead, or maybe I should call suicide hotline. Tell them about all my problems. See if they know how to solve them. Happy birthday, Tim. That is so cute.
There's a cat and a dog.
Oh, can I see? Oh my gosh.
No, that's a dog. They're both.
Oh, they're both dogs?
One's named Roxy, one's named Boxy.
Yeah, what kind of dogs are they?
So
what kind of dogs are they? They're what kind of dogs?
Boxers.
One looks like a Boston Terrier.
They're boxers, get it?
They're both boxers.
You are the best uncle in the world. Have a boxational day. Wow.
She made up that word, boxational.
That's a good one.
That is so
funny. That is so funny. I love it. Oh, and it's wearing Kimla shorts. Oh my gosh.
Awesome. 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 Team.
I love the face, Stella. This is so good. Yeah, yeah, you're wearing Fear of God now.
Yes.
Whoa!
Oh, good.
Good, good.
Happy birthday!